just done my interview. Hi guys, welcome to my channel. For those who don't know me, my name is Justice, and today I'm sharing my experience adjustment of status or permanent of residence here in the United States. So let's start. I came from the Philippines. I moved here in the US August 8, 2018 through a visa. This fiancé visa has 90 days validity, so within that 90 days on or before, you have to get married. We got married September 21st, 2018 and submitted our application for the adjustment of status October 9th. That time, it takes 18 months for my green card to be issued. But before they gonna issue your green card, they gonna conduct an interview together with your spouse. I received a notice of action for my initial interview. That would be January 28, 2020, around 9:30 a.m. I made a checklist for this, just to make sure that I had everything and make sure to bring original if you still have original. We have the notice for interview and the government ID, so you have to bring this letter. And then the vaccination, it says medical examination, I-693 and a vaccination supplement sealed envelope unless already submitted. I didn't provide any 1693 form since I already submitted it during my entry, but some of the girls about it. So, but luckily on my part, I didn't go through with that. So they also want the affidavit of support, which is the I-864. But it says unless you already submitted it, and I did during my application, I attached this form. And then under affidavit of support, you need to have a copy of certificate of employment. This is all for your husband or your co-sponsor. A copy of form 1040 for the past 3 years. A copy of W-2s for past 3 years, then a recent pay stubs for about like 3 months. So next is documentation establishing your eligibility for lawful permanent residence status. What I did is I just brought a copy of my notice and approved I-129F petitions. Every documents that I receive from the USCIS, I bring that. And next is a copy of my passport, and I also include my husband's passport. Then a copy of my K-1 visa page and the US entry stamp. A copy of form I-94. The arrival departure record. Since I went back to the Philippines, I need to get an updated record, so I got a new one. And then a copy of your birth certificate, also of your husband. Then certified copy of marriage certificate. A copy of divorce decree if your spouse has been divorced before. Next is proof of relationship. I provided a couple of wedding photos that I made. So, like that. this one because we got married twice. And then I include our like trips or like vacation or anything that involves our family. Next is our credit card bill, our insurance, and then I included report of marriage in the Philippines, and then tax returns. So during my interview, that was January 28th, 9:30 a.m. You have to be there 30 minutes before your interview. So during the interview, an immigration officer led us to her office and make us swear that we're telling the truth and nothing but truth. So help you God. So okay. So she asked for my passport and my husband's passport. Good thing we brought it. And then she asked for my ID also and my husband's ID. So after that, she ran through a couple of questions that I filled out in the USCIS form I-485, and she just ran through some of the questions just to make sure that I'm saying the truth or making sure that whatever I input here in the form is true. The immigration takes longer on the interview because she has to do this general eligibility and admissibility grounds, which has these criminal acts and violations. So she has to ask again if, like, have you ever been denied admission of the United States, or have you ever been convicted or two or more offenses. So it's for legal matters and she needs to really go through with it. Okay, so after the interview, she asked me the proof of relationship, which is I provided her the a copy of this, because I made two copies, and then our credit card bill, she also took that one, a copy of our insurance, then a copy of report of marriage and the tax returns. So she took all of it, and for the affidavit of support, she only took the recent one, which is last year, ITR and the W-2, and then she also took my husband's certificate of employment. After gathering all the documents that the immigration officer needed, she handed us two papers. First, the letter for the applicant saying that the affidavit of support filed with your application to become a lawful permanent resident is a contract between your sponsor and the government of the United States. This means that your sponsor is telling the government that he or she is willing and able to financially support you if needed. It also makes you ineligible for certain federal, state, or local means tested benefits, because he indicated that he will support you. So yes, I give this one. And then the result of my interview, which is they can't determine the final decision yet. My case is being held for review. Can't determine when will my case be approved, and they give me 120 days for me to inquire about my case. So I answered everything truthfully and correctly, but I was not approved right away compared to other applicants who go through the interview. Because as what he told us, I have a lack in documents. That's it. After my interview, I waited 2 months for a status, which is the approval of my green card. They will send you this letter, the notice of action, which is the approval notice. And I got approved April 1, and after that, April 3, my status changed again. They mailed a new card to me. Today, I got this. Finally, after 18 months, the long wait is over. So I got 2 years validity. So after this, I'm gonna apply for removal of conditions or citizenship. So don't forget to subscribe and please like and comment on this video. If you need some help, just message me and I will do my best to help you guys. Bye. Take five. It's a